जो बच्चे नहीं हैं उनके लिए YouTube में हम लेक्चर बना देंगे, तो वो बच्चे वहाँ से YouTube से डाउनलोड करके उसको पढ़ लेंगे, वो ऑलवेज वहाँ पढ़ा रहेगा। देखो, हम लोग पिछले क्लास में इटरेशन न्यूटन रैफसन मेथड पढ़ चुके थे, उस पर एग्जाम्पल भी हमने दो लगा लिया, तीन एग्जाम्पल था। नाउ ए क्वेश्चन फॉर यू, फॉर्मुलेट इटरेशन फॉर्मूला फॉर द फंक्शन ई टू द पावर एक्स टेन एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन यूजिंग न्यूटन रैफसन मेथड। तो यूज न्यूटन रैफसन मेथड एंड फॉर्मुलेट ए फॉर्मूला। अब तुम लोग कहीं बात नहीं करो, क्लास करो शांति से। देखो इसका एक्सप्लेनेशन क्या है, फिगर ज्योमेट्रिकल एक्सप्लेनेशन क्या है। इन दिस मेथड द पार्ट ऑफ द कर्व, देखो पहले फिगर देख लो, फिगर देखो, दिस इज योर कर्व, ओ एक्स एक्स एक्सिस, ओ वाई इज योर वाई एक्सिस, दिस पॉइंट इज योर एक्स जीरो एफ एक्स जीरो, एट दिस पॉइंट ड्रॉ ए टेंजेंट विच कट्स द एक्स एक्सिस एट एक्स वन जीरो, so this point is x0 fx0, draw a perpendicular, so at the x axis, so this point is x0 0. Now see the geometrical explanation. In this method the part of the curve between point x0 fx0 and the x axis is replaced by the tangent to the curve at x0 fx0. humne x0 fx0 pe ek tangent draw kiya, aur tangent x axis ko cut karta hai, तो जो कर्व का पोर्शन है उस पोर्शन को हम टेंजेंट से रिप्लेस करते हैं। वी यूज इट फॉर एल्जेब्रिक एंड ट्रांसेंडेंटल इक्वेशंस बोथ। सी दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ द कर्व, तो दिस पार्ट इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय दिस टेंजेंट। नाउ वी हैव अ नेक्स्ट मेथड दैट इज कॉल्ड सेकेंड मेथड, दिस इज योर लास्ट मेथड, फर्स्ट वॉज योर बाइसेक्शन मेथड, सेकेंड इज न्यूटन रैफसन, now this is your second method. In this method a part of the function fx is replaced by a chord, so here we have axis ox and oy, this is your curve, amb is your curve, the part of this curve b to m is replaced, or you can say amb, this part of the curve is replaced by a chord ab, join a to b by a straight line, so this part is replaced by the chord AB. Here also FA into FB should be less than zero, so you can see this point A is small AFA, FA is negative, and this point B is small BFB, so FB is positive, so FA into FB will be less than zero. Let FA be less than zero and FB be greater than zero, we have assumed in the figure also. Then here the part of the curve AMB in the points A, AFA and BFB is, next page, is replaced by the chord AB joining points A and B. Okay, equation of this chord is given by, remember earlier in your intermediate classes you have studied that a straight line joining two points x1, y1 and x2, y2 will be y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. So it is just a reminder of the same. So y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 means fb minus fa, or x2 minus x1 means b minus a into x minus a into x minus x1 means x minus a. So at the point of intersection means where the curve crosses the x-axis, y will be zero since y at x-axis is zero. So one implies that substitute here y is equal to zero. 0 minus FA is equal to FB minus FA or B minus A into X minus A. So evaluate the value of X from this equation. So X will be A into FB minus B into FA by FB minus FA. Let us denote it by X1. Denote it, this value of X by X1. So X1 is A into FB minus B into FA by FB minus FA. Again, FX1 is equal to 0 implies that X1 is the root. If FX1 is 0, then X1 will be the root. Otherwise, we have two cases. Case one, fx1 is greater than zero, then x2 will be in a and x1. Since fa is less than zero and fx1 is greater than zero, so x2 will be in a and x1. And case two, fx1 less than zero, then x2 will be in x1b, since fb is greater than zero and fx1 is less than zero, so x2 will belong to this one. Because we have the property, we fulfill the property fa into fb less than zero. we repeat this procedure and get x n plus 1 is equal to x n minus 1 f x n minus x n f x n minus 1 over f x n minus f x n minus 1. It can be written as is equal to x n minus x n minus x n minus 1 into f x n over f x n minus f x n minus 1, provided f x n minus 1 into f x n is less than 0 at each step. You need to check it at each step that this property is fulfilled. So x n plus 1 will be x n minus f x n divided by f x n minus 1 by x n minus 1. Divide this x n minus x n minus 1 for over this. So this method is called second method. Now let us see one example, and after this you should write it in your note copy. Example 1. Compute the root of x cube minus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0 in the interval 1, 2. This is our interval by the second method. It is given in the problem that this problem should be solved by second method. Perform 4 iterations. It is also given that you should perform 4 iterations. Solution. Here it is given that fx is your x cube minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. This is your equation. And interval is 1, 2. Since now evaluate f1 and f2. F1 is 1 cube minus 5 into 1 plus 3. Substitute x is equal to 1 in this equation. So this is minus 1 less than 0. And f2 is 2 cube minus 5 into 2 plus 3. It is equal to 1 greater than 0. So this is f1 into f2 will be less than 0. It means 1 root lies between 1, 2. In the interval 1, 2. Therefore, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2. The second method gives xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus 1 into fxn minus xn fxn minus 1 divided by fxn minus fxn minus 1. Use this formula of second method. For n is equal to 1, x0 is equal to 1, x1 is equal to 2, and fx0 is equal to minus 1, fx1 is equal to 1. See here the values. Substitute these values. Then you get x2 is equal to x0 fx1 minus x1 fx0 over fx1 minus fx0. Substitute the values. This is equal to 1 into 1 minus 2 into minus 1 by 1 minus minus 1. So it is 1.5. Now fx2 will be 1. Substitute in this formula x cube minus 5x plus 3. So fx2 will be 1.5 cube minus 5 into 1.5 plus 3. This is equal to minus 1.125, which is your less than 0. So it is a mistake. It should be less than 0. So x3 will belongs to 1.5 and 2. 1.5 and 2. Since fx2 is greater than 0, means f2 is greater than 0, and f 1.5 is less than 0. It should be less than 0. Therefore, x3 belongs to x2, x1. So the next iteration, x3 is given by x3 is equal to x2 fx1 minus x1 fx2 by fx1 minus fx0. Use the formula of second method. Now substitute the values. X2 is 1.5, fx1 is 1, minus x1 is 2, and fx2 is minus 1.125. Divided by fx1 is 1, minus fx2 is minus 1.125. After simplification, we get 1.7647059. Now fx3 is equal to x3 cube minus 5x3 plus 3. It is equal to minus 0.3279, which is less than 0. So then x4 will belong to x3, x1, that is x4 belongs to 1.7647059 and 2. Therefore, x4 will be given as x3 fx1 minus x1 fx3 over fx1 minus fx3. Substitute the values here, and you get x4 is equal to 1.82281. Now, fx4 is minus 0.057515, it is less than 0. So x5 will belongs to x4, x1, that is x5 belongs to 1.82281. On 2, evaluate x5 using second method. X5 is equal to x4 into fx1 minus x1 into fx4 by fx1 minus fx4. Substitute the values, and you get x5 is equal to 1.83244. Here, in solving numerical method problem, you can use a scientific calculator. This is our answer, since we need to make 4 iterations. See one more example. Solve x cube minus 18 is equal to 0 by using second method in the interval 2, 3. Here fx is x cube minus 18, and f2 is 2 cube minus 18, it is minus 10 less than 0, and f3 is 3 cube minus 18, it is 10, 9 greater than 0. So f2 into f3 is less than 0. Thus x0 will be taken as 2 and x1 will be taken as 3, and fx0 is equal to fx2 means minus 10, and fx1 is f3 is 9. Next, we should evaluate next iterations. सेकंड मेथड गिव्स द फॉर्मूला एक्स एन प्लस वन इज इक्वल एक्स एन माइनस वन एफ एक्स एन माइनस एक्स एन एफ एक्स एन माइनस वन ओवर एफ एक्स एन माइनस एफ एक्स एन माइनस वन. रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूला फॉर एन इज इक्वल वन एक्स टू विल बी एक्स जीरो एफ एक्स वन माइनस एक्स वन एफ एक्स टू बाई एक्स वन एफ एक्स वन माइनस एफ एक्स टू. सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज ऑफ ऑल दिस टू इंटू नाइन माइनस थ्री इंटू माइनस टेन बाई नाइन माइनस माइनस टेन सो इट विल बी टू पॉइंट फाइव टू सिक्स थ्री वन. इवैल्यूएट एफ एक्स टू इट विल बी एक्स टू क्यूब माइनस एटीन. So its value comes out to be one minus 1.87648, which is less than zero. Therefore, x3 will belongs to x2, x1. That is, x3 belongs to 2.52631 and 3. Next, x3 will be given as x2 fx1 minus x1 fx2 by fx1 minus fx2. Substitute the values and you get x3 2.60803. Again, evaluate fx3. It will be minus 0.26065, which is less than zero. Here, fx is x3 minus 18. Evaluate the value of x here. Therefore, x4 will belongs to will belong to x3, x1. That is, x4 belongs to 2.60803 and 3. Thus, x4 is given as x3 fx1 minus x1 fx3 over fx1 minus fx3. After substitution of the values, you get x4 2.61906, and fx4 is given as minus 0.03462, which is less than zero. Therefore, x5 will belong to x5, x4, x1. That is, x5 belongs to 2.61906 and 3. And the last one is x5 is x4 fx1 minus x1 fx4 over fx1 minus fx4. After substitution of the values, you get x5 is equal to 2.62052 and fx5 is this one less than zero. Therefore, x6 will belong to x5, x1 and x6 belongs to 2.62052 and 3. No need to go further. If it is not given in the problem, stop here. It is the last step. Okay, after this, there are two more examples. Okay, so you just write, note down this, and if you have any query, ask me here, raise your hand and ask me your problem.